Hey everyone, this is Sean with DPC Technology. Today we're running a bunch of data cables for a new doctor's office buildout, and we're running about 145 data line runs for all of his Ethernet drops, TVs, computers, wireless access points, phones. So make sure you guys stick around because we're going to show you a bunch of tips and tricks as far as things that we've discovered over the years of running cable that help us get things done more efficiently, keeping things organized and neat for everybody else on site so that you guys aren't the ones that are hated. Normally we're the guys on site and they're like, all the geeks are showing up, right? Great. All the nerds are here. So you want to make sure you know your way around a job site so that you can handle yourself and make sure you're not getting in anybody else's way.
I want it out of the walkway of the crawl space so if we can go on the outside of that.
Okay.
Inside of this, as long as it's in the hallway, right?
Yeah.
Just on the left side outside, running along there.
So the main goal today, we're going to create a main trunk of cable that runs down the center of the building. It's going to run along the hallway across the entire building. We're going to hang a bunch of J-hooks about every 6 feet to keep our cables tacked up out of everybody's way, nice and neat in the bundle. We're running Cat6 cable today because that's the industry standard. The main purpose of the trunk is to keep all our cables consolidated in one line. And then from there, when we get to the rooms that we're going to, we're gonna drop them in the room and branch out to where we need to go. This keeps everything nice and clean along the center. You don't have cables just running everywhere. And if you start running wires just directly to where you need to go everywhere, contractors are gonna hate you. Everybody on site will get pissed because your cables are in the way and you'll probably end up with some of your cables cut. The goal is to scope out what our main line is gonna be, where it's gonna be, hang the J-hook infrastructure for all our line runs, and then start running them. We wanna do our first runs to the far corners of the building because then you've got your main line established all the way to the very end, and then the main line established all the way to the very other end. It also helps us scope out any problems we might hit. Somebody has a duct that comes in front of us or somebody has their exhaust pipe coming out. So we can dodge all those things, pre-plan for all of that. And then all it comes down to is just cranking it out, start running the lines. It's just like anything else. If you're prepping your car to paint it, good prep makes light work. Drop down here. This is gonna be two blacks and a blue.
Okay.
Over here, two blacks and a blue. And then TV up there. One single black. So divvy that up what you can. I think we're missing one blue cable out of this bundle. So, you know, if you run it straight to the pipe, I guess see that pipe over there? It's down there. But if you run it straight to the pipe, throw it down, and then we'll leave enough slack that we can hook up a J-hook and then hang the wires on it, right? So do all these three, one, you know, bundle. Pull out extra slack out here, you know, basically out to this wall and down. And then you both can work in this section alone. You don't have to have somebody back in the closet still. That way you guys can both work together about getting these down each spot.
Okay.
So I only have three people on site. This allows me to be the one coordinating and then two guys, one running the line from the closet. He's pulling the cable out of the boxes and feeding to the guy that's running the lines on the other end. And then there's a floater just coming and jumping in. Maybe the cable gets caught in the middle. You jump up and grab it and start pulling it and help him get it through. This job is big enough that I've got five people. That way I've got two teams of two running around, running lines. This is the side of IT that people don't really think about. When I first started in IT, I was expecting to be just help desk technician, sitting behind the desk, answering questions and make sure that, you know, the computer was turned off after somebody had a problem. But instead, I ended up being on site more times than not. I was mounting TVs, running cables, mounting wireless access points. All of that comes with IT as well. And this is kind of the aspect I like most, is being on site, working with my hands, talking to people, working on problems, solving things as they come up. So as we get into every single room, we end up having to run down the conduit that they've ran for us. So we'll either be able to fish the wires just straight down the pipe by just pushing them down. If it ends up being too constricted or there's too many bends in the pipe, we'll end up running a fish tape. That's just a little spool of wire that we're able to stick up the pipe. It stays firm so you can kind of fish it all the way up to the top, tape to it on the top, and then pull the wire down. We do have a video about cabling for this exact purpose, behind the walls, how to fish the wire up the wall, things like that. I'll put that in the description below. If you hit a case like that where you don't see but it's on here,
yeah,
you can always run the black cable all the way to here. Like there's even a hole that looks like that would have been it, right?
Right.
And then we can ask him to add the conduit and we'll just poke it down it.
Okay. Sounds good.
Yeah. I didn't even notice. All right. So here we are at the end of the initial wiring phase. We've got all of our data drops going to where they need to go. And we have our nice big bundle all collected in the closet here. The electrician ran us some giant 3-inch conduits on either side to drop our wires through. So that way we have a nice clean penetration through the ceiling. So we ran into a few challenges while we were here this week. One of them being is they have millwork at their front desk, which is essentially a front desk with no connection to the walls. It's just built off of the ground. and that always comes in last, so we always get there ahead of time. So what we'll end up doing is running our wires above the ceiling. That way when they seal off the ceiling, our wires aren't getting cut off, and it's just up there in a spool ready for us to come back. When the millwork has been built out, we'll fish those lines down the conduit into the front desk. Another issue we ran into was some things were just not where we expected them to be. You can plan all day, but when you get on site, something always changes. We had TVs that moved from one wall to another and you don't expect it. One of the other issues we were having is the electrician didn't finish his conduits on the east side of the building. So we ended up just running our wires above the ceiling grid and then tacking up and rolling them up as well above the grid. That way, when we come back and he actually finishes his conduit, we could just unravel those wires and throw it down the pipe. Unfortunately, this is a little bit of double work for us because we have to now come back again and throw the wires down the pipe, but it is what it is. That's kind of how things go. Another one of the issues that I've experienced this week is the importance of planning and having every single person on your team on the same page. I was the one that put together the plans for where every single data drop is going, where every single HDMI cable is running, where the pipes are, where the conduits are going to be. And my team had a lot of questions for me because they just didn't have the plans in their head as much as I did. So I could have had a little more prep to inform them of where everything's going to be, review the plans with them prior to even showing on site. That way everybody's on the same page. On the last day, we're going through and finishing up all of our cables. This includes tacking them up above the ceiling grid, making sure that the lines above the grid do not contact any other line that's up there. This includes electricians' conduits, the fire conduits, AC ducting, heat exhaust vents. All of those things can't be touched. There's a code that basically says nobody's stuff can touch anybody else's stuff. So we want to make sure that all of our lines are tacked up above. That way there's no chance of them drooping down and touching something else and possibly getting burnt or creating a short circuit in the wiring. And this pretty much concludes our initial wiring phase of this project. We'll probably be back in about a month to terminate the cables at the wall plates and terminate the closet into patch panels. The initial wiring of this building will be ready for computers. I have another video where I've shown how I terminate data closets and the process behind that and why I design it the way I do. That will be probably floating around my head somewhere here, so make sure you guys click on that and take a look at that.